Hi, I'm Nay from Nay Nay Makes, and for this tutorial I will be demonstrating how to attach a pattern to a clasp handle. Every clasp handle is completely different in design, and as long as you have holes pierced through your handle, you can work your pattern into your handle depending on the amount of numbers of holes that are punched into the clasp handle. I think there is roughly 47 on this clasp handle I have here. So with my design, I worked out how many stitches I would need to create a pattern. So depending on the pattern and the style of handbag or clasp handle that you wanted to make for your bag, depends on how many stitches you can work up. It doesn't need to match the numbers that you have on your clasp handle, because for this pattern I worked up the stitches I needed to make the pattern that I wanted, and then towards the top of my pattern I shrank it down by detogging on three different rows, I think it was, for this one. I've detogged on the sides to bring it to the number of stitches that I needed for my clasp handle. Now, to attach it properly so that you have it in a straight row along the top, we do not include, for my style handbag, I have a curve on the side. So bearing in mind, if your clasp handle goes all the way to the end, then you would attach the amount of stitches you need at the top here to however straight your clasp handle top is. For mine, it curves quite nicely quite down the sides here. So I worked out how many stitches I would need to roughly the middle of the bend here. I stopped about there and then added these to my side. So the number of holes I've got punched in the side of my clasp would be down the side of my piece of the pattern shape. So in order to work it out, I worked out how many stitches I had along the top of the clasp handle, and I added two or three either side so that the corners could bend nicely around. I added two to each end. And for the centre pieces, I wanted my cables to stick out or punch outwards so that we had bulges, so that they were prominent out for the pattern. I detogged, or rather added two of the stitches into one. I think probably there, there, and there. So you can shrink it down to however you wanted to, rather than trying to squeeze all of them into one. You can join two into one, join two into one. So I will show you, using this side to attach to the other side to this, using a darning needle and some extra yarn. I normally measure along from one side to the other and then do it again, just to work out how much. Probably do it again, so three times the length to cut the desired length that you'd need to attach. Thread your needle. I'm actually doing this the wrong way around. And then finding the side of my pattern. I think it was roughly, let's see on this. About here. Attaching my yarn the side post, leaving enough tail to sew in. I normally just tie with a simple knot. And then opening up on this side here, open up my clasp. I want to attach it to the first dot hole we have punctured in here. So making sure my piece is the right way around. Here is my corner. I'm going to attach it to here by going through with my darning needle. And there we are, one attached corner. Now I'm going to work through exactly the same place and the same hole, just to give it that extra piece of strength for my corner. Let's find the right tail, because I've obviously got the other side's tail as well to work with. Where is it there? Let's pull that out and pull that one. There we go. Now, if you hold your corner here, this is my last stitch up the top here. If I hold that in place, so I know roughly whereabouts to place my next stitch, so roughly about here, and then go into the next hole. Let's bring that bit round here. Excuse my stomach. And then roughly again, so it's not essential to be exact on how to place them, but you can kind of guess mark where, and then there, and then probably bring that a bit lower down, so that we're not overstretching the stitches to the hole. Now this one here, and this one here, I'm going to class as my corner. So here's my corner stitch there. I'm going to add another one from this last DC I made on this row here. I'm going to add it to that first part of the corner. And then find my first stitch, which is here by the look of it. Does that look like my first stitch there? Or is that one my first stitch? Let's try the middle of that DC there into the middle of the corner. And try that one again with another stitch, so that we've got two through the same hole, and that kind of gives us a bit of a stronger corner. Now this is the top of my chain along the top here. This is the first row of stitches, so I'm going to add that one also to this same corner. I can find the hole because I'm doing it blind from the back. Where is it? And give it a wiggle to get them through. There we go, that's our first in our row added to that side corner. And then I'm going to pick up the second one that's down, the second row down, and then add it to that one next to, I think that might be the final for our corner. And then add another one, so that we've got two for that corner. This just gives us a bit of a strength, makes it a bit tighter in my corner there. And then find the next stitch along and add to the next hole, find my next stitch along, and add that one to the next hole. And then find my next stitch, add that one to the next hole. And then find my next stitch, add that one to the hole. Find my next stitch, add that one to the next hole, and continue till I think we've got the end of my ripple here. I could possibly add maybe two, because this is the middle of my ripple for my cable pattern. I could add my next one in, and possibly that one as well into the same hole, just to bring them together a bit. That one's the next one into the next hole, so that we're bunching it up slightly, because we'd like it to ripple a little bit to bring out this part of the pattern a bit. And plus we have to fit all the way to here. Has to fit to here, so I need to bunch them up to fit possibly two stitches into, well, you can kind of work out if you get halfway how many you've done here and how many you've got left, but it is definitely working to eye to know what you've got left to work with. I might add that one as well to the same stitch, just so I'm not left with too many in the, before I get to the middle. Add that one to the same stitch as well, or rather the same hole. And keep going. That one already done, yep. It's easy to use the same stitches twice as well if you don't know you've already gone through it. So it kind of looks like it hasn't been attached, but it has, look there. So make sure you are going into the next one rather than using the same stitch twice. There's the next one. Now these are fitting in quite nicely. As I get to the corner, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, maybe 14 for the last corner. And for my stitches, I've used that one already. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. I have 16 stitches left and 14 holes, which I can add the last two, possibly here and here. So we're going okay without having to bunch up any more, really. Maybe on the last ripple. So it does depend on the amount of holes that you have in your clasp to how big you want to make your pattern, because the number of holes doesn't need to match the number of stitches that you've got on your pattern. Because with this style bag, I wanted it to be quite big internally for the base, so the bottom of it is quite long. But these posts at the end will be my edge, so when I join the sides, they'll be brought together as a side post to the bag. So you really have to kind of work it out what it is that you want for your bag, the shape of the bag, the size. Let's add that one to the same one. It's really hard to kind of work out where the back of the... There we go. Leave myself a bit more thread. And the next one. You really do have to have quite a strong darning needle as well to get around and through. And that one there. This one doesn't want to go through. There we go. And what have I got left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We can add another one to this one. So 1, 2, 2 to that one, 2 to that one. Same as the other corner. That one already used. Yep, so that one next. Into the same corner. So there's two in that one, and then grab the next one. Trying to get around the bend because we're in the corner now and it's quite tight. There we go. Last 1, 2, 3 stitches in the pattern. 1, 2 corners, so we can add one to that one there. Some noisy handles, by the way, that are rattling. And then add the next one to the same hole again for the corner. So we're adding the last few stitches into the same holes of the clasp for the corner, just to make it a bit stronger. And then we have one more in my top row to add to possibly that one or that one for the corner as we bend round. Somebody at my door then, I think. And then bring that one in. And now we have the corner securely made into the corner. Let's see if we can add another just to tighten it a bit more. And then we have our top row added all the way along. Now for the last side to match this side here, we have, there's my loose tail from the pattern. If I bring that one in, I can sew that in later. We've gone down to this part here for this part here. So if we match it and find out where we've gone down on that side. I've only got this amount of wool left as well, which is going to be tricky, but we'll see if we can squeeze them all down. Let's bring that through. Now I'm going down the sides of these posts here that are on the row leading up to the last row. So it is just finding where we're strong enough to go through the post and then bringing it through the side holes. There we go. Last three stitches. And then possibly there. Made it. And then I'm just going to sew in that last tail all the way up. It looks rather worn out now, seeing as it's been pulled through all of these holes. And there we go. That is how I sew on my clasp handles. I hope this tutorial has helped you in any way. If you have any questions regarding your own clasp handle that you are trying to attach your project to, let me know. I'll try and work out maybe a pattern and the amount of stitches that you need, possibly what corner stitches you need, what side stitches you need, to work out how to snugly fit your handles on, and always leave yourself enough yarn as well either side so that I can now attach my yarn needle to the sides. And for my one, I'm going to attach them so that they have their posts. How is this easiest to hold? So show you. So that the posts are joined together like that there. Or possibly fold them over to make a thicker side all the way down. So I have a side panel. And then please check out my Instagram for my final finished product, for what I want to do to the end of it once it's all sewn together. Please check out my Instagram for the final piece. I hope this tutorial has helped you. Please leave a comment, like and subscribe for my YouTube channel. And thank you so much for watching. I hope it's worth the wait. And I'll see you soon. Thank you.